Celebrations mark the end of British rule in Belize, but our troops will stay on. Hello again. The Union flag was lowered for the last time last night in the tiny country of Belize. She's got her independence after 120 years under British control. The little state in Central America was founded by shipwrecked British sailors, and it's the last place on the American continent to get independence from Britain. But Belize has already got its problems. One of its neighbors, Guatemala, has claimed for years that Belize really belongs to her, and she's not recognizing Belize as an independent state. So independence ceremonies wasn't a wholehearted celebration. Many local people didn't want to break off the ties with Britain because of fears about Guatemala. And few saw the new blue and red flag of Belize raised. But despite that, the country became independent from Britain last night. About a third of the 140,000 Belizeans live in Belize City. Much of the rest of the country is swamp and jungle. And many of the people there are very poor. Still, the Guatemalans who've been demonstrating against the independence today would still like to control Belize. But Britain has warned Guatemala not to try to invade. Prince Michael of Kent was at the independence celebrations, as Martin Bell reports.
Prince Michael of Kent, cousin to the Queen, is going the rounds of some of the remoter places in Belize. And this is a country where just about everywhere is remote, except Belize City itself. He's watching cultural displays and dances in a variety of costumes and rhythms. This one, a Mayan sword dance. There are many others. The prince is in the process of doing what the royal family have been doing regularly for more than 20 years, giving independence to countries that used to be British. It's a familiar routine. The Union Jack is put away, the country runs its own affairs, and the British pack up and go home. Except that in this case, the British are not going home. It was as a token of that that the prince also visited an army camp in the hill country here and talked to the troops there, the Gurkhas and Gordon Highlanders, who are staying on after independence. The government of the new nation doesn't want the British troops to leave because of the threat of invasion from neighboring Guatemala. In this corner of the country, the Gurkhas, who are part of the British army, man border posts. They showed the prince some of the tents and bivouacs they use, and they discourage the Guatemalans from trying to come across. So far, it's worked. And because of the dispute with Guatemala, the new nation of Belize is going to need the troops to stay for a long time to come. Martin Bell in Punta Gorda, Belize, for Newsround.
Making the country's 150,000 inhabitants citizens of the 45th British Commonwealth state. But neighbouring Guatemala is refusing to accept Belize's independence and has broken off relations with Britain. Martin Bell reporting.
On Belize's last day as a colony, Prince Michael and the princess attended a service of thanksgiving for the birth of the new nation. The rituals of independence are unchanging for this as for other former British possessions. The only sign of the special circumstances is the quite unusual security. Even at the cathedral, the prince and princess were under what's called close protection from a group of between 4 and 8 plain-clothed security men identified as regimental police. But the SAS are also said to be involved in the operation. The reason? Despite the services of thanksgiving, Belize isn't passing to independence exactly as the British would have liked. There's still a threat to its internal security as to its external defense. Independence Day, of course, is a national holiday, but it can hardly be observed as one in forward army bases as here at Salamanca in the southwest of the country, also visited by the prince. Salamanca is the headquarters of a company of Gurkhas, the Nepalese hill people who are among the most effective troops the army has ever had here. In this hill country, they patrol and guard the border against possible Guatemalan incursions. And Prince Michael, until recently a serving soldier himself, inspected the men and equipment of a Gurkha patrol. The rifle they use, the American Armalite, lighter than its British equivalent. And the bivouacs, where they find shelter from a rainfall of up to an inch a day. For the Gurkhas, as for the rest of the garrison, the coming of independence changes nothing. They'll stay, the British say, for an appropriate period. It's a commitment to the security of the country, but not an open-ended one, as the government knows full well. On the eve of independence, the Gordon Highlanders, who steal the show wherever they appear, staged the ceremony of beating the retreat. It was a phrase seized on by visiting journalists from such countries as Cuba and Nicaragua, where they don't understand these things, to indicate a British retreat from Belize. It's nothing of the sort. With independence over, only the band goes home. The garrison soldiers on. Martin Bell, BBC, Belize.
Britain today issued a warning to Guatemala, without naming her, not to invade Belize. The Foreign Office says in a statement that if the new nation is attacked or is threatened with invasion, Britain will consult with Canada and Caribbean members of the Commonwealth to consider retaliatory measures.